So I've been talking about long channel and short channel devices for quite some time. So let me just define what I mean by long channel and short channel devices. So long channel and short channel devices. So if you take a MOSFET, we have been drawing the MOSFET. N plus source and drain regions, silicon dioxide and gate. Okay, gate, source, drain. Okay, similarly let me draw another MOSFET, which is the so-called short channel. Let's call this as long channel. So short channel MOSFET, so it will look something like this. This is the gate, N plus source, N plus drain. Okay, this is the P bulk and this is the P bulk here. Right, now let us call this particular region as L1, I mean this length as L1, and let us call this length as L2, and this L1 is of course much greater than L2. Okay, and we need to say what is the, you know, actual definition for the transistor on the left to be called as a long channel and this to be called as a short channel, right? So here comes the, you know, importance of the electric field. We know that we have some vertical electric field EV in the direction that I mentioned here. Basically you put a positive voltage here and then positive to negative, you have some vertical electric field. Similarly you put a positive voltage on the drain also, so you have a lateral electric field in this direction. Okay, in the direction here. So this vertical electric field will collect the electrons here, and then this lateral electric field will help in the movement of the electrons from source to drain, or current from drain to source. Okay, and similarly here also you have some vertical electric field and you have some lateral electric field, right? So vertical electric field is you know, in simple terms you can, you know, mention it as V by L. okay, so the magnitude of the electric field you can simply write it as V by L, and this voltage, for the vertical voltage that we are talking about, is VGS, and the distance is basically this TOX, because the vertical electric field is acting from the gate to collect the electrons here. So basically the distance is essentially my TOX. Okay, and let me call it TOX1, and here the vertical electric field is again the VGS by TOX2. Let us call this one as TOX2. This is TOX1 and this one is TOX2. Okay, and the lateral electric field is nothing but VDS by L1. Okay, because VDS is the lateral voltage, D and S. Okay, so here also the lateral electric field is VDS by L2. Okay, if the vertical electric field is much larger than the lateral electric field, if this condition is true, then it is called as a long channel MOSFET. Okay, so let us see why it is true here. If you see, this L1 is very large. We have stated that L1 is very large. So if L1 is large, then lateral electric field reduces by a large amount, and TOX is usually a very small quantity. For the same value of VDS and VGS, let us keep the VDS as well as the VGS as the highest potential that can be supplied by the circuit. Okay, then for, you know, TOX is almost orders of magnitude smaller than L1. Okay, now in that case what happens, EV will be much larger than EL. And so it is true for long channel device. This condition will hold true. That is why we are calling it as a long channel device. But on the other hand, if you again keep VGS and VDS at the highest potential given by the circuit, let's say VGS is equal to VDS, still this TOX2 will be almost or more or less in the same order of L2, or L2 will almost be in the same order of TOX2. There won't be orders of magnitude difference, okay, for a short channel device. The length will be shrunk by a large amount, that it is almost close to TOX value, okay, and that is why it is called as a short channel device. And you know, it is mostly classified due to the electric field or due to the oxide thickness, and comparison between the oxide thickness and the channel length, okay, it's indirectly related to the electric field, and that is why you classify the device as, you know, that is how you classify the device as long channel and short channel, okay. So I hope it is clear, like whenever we talk about long channel and small channels, and almost as I said, long channel devices are like on the upside of 500 nanometer technology node. Like we call it, we call the channel length more, I mean, approximately you can say a technology node will be equal to that of the channel length. And for 500 nanometer, 250 nanometer channel length and all, you know, it is long channel. Even, you know, to some extent 180 nanometer can be classified here also as long channel, and then, you know, sometimes, you know, it behaves as, you know, it can also classify it as short channel. That's why we are dealing with 180 nanometer, and then you know, 180, and then, you know, on the lower side of 180, 130, 90, 65, 45, and so on are short channel devices, okay. So in our course we'll be mostly dealing with 180 nanometer technology and parameters corresponding to that, okay.